capital of the snake pit, the Shark Tank, known formerly as the Thomas and Mack Center, home of the UNLV run-in Rebels, today hosting the Wildcats of Arizona. Here's why I call it the capital of snake pit, because you just don't beat the run-in Rebels here very often. 101-6, my goodness. It's the kind of a place where you go to season a team for postseason play. And that's exactly what both are doing today. Turn now to Dick Vitale and talk about the two front lines, because they are very good, but they're different.
Keith, I'll tell you one thing. When we talk about the running Rebels front court, we're talking about the premier front court in the nation. Also, Vegas has the best starting five in the nation. Take a look at those numbers. Larry Johnson, David Butler, and Stacey Augman really complement each other. Johnson's a big-time scorer, and Stacey Augman is the best defensive player on the baseline in college basketball.
Now, the difference between them simply rests in the fact that Arizona's front line is so young, with the exception of Bushler.
Brian Williams is certainly a guy with a lot of potential, has to develop a little bit better work ethic. Stokes has been a diaper dandy, a shot blocker. And Jed Bushler is an all-purpose player. And then they have a key guy coming off the bench, Sean Rook. There'll be a lot of clawing, a lot of clashing, a lot of banging inside. And remember, Vegas has to win all of its games and be 30-4 to get the number one seed in the West.
And the point man for the Rebels, Greg Anthony, playing with a broken jaw.
I can hear it.
There's something coming. Transform
like you never seen.
Transform. It's a new kind of driving machine. Get on your party.
The space vehicle of the 90s. Introducing the Pontiac of minivans, the new Pontiac Transport.
Ride, Transport, ride on your Pontiac.
We build excitement.
Transport, Transport, ride.
BF Goodrich TA Tires.
BF Goodrich TA Tires perform like great athletic shoes. They grab. They dig.
BF Goodrich
TA Tires, the athletic shoes for your car.
BF Goodrich TA Tires.
So your little brother's joining us, huh?
He's not so little anymore.
All right, now let's move it!
He's what, 19?
Weight setting, 540, F-14.
Jeff's landing planes?
Four gear lens set.
No. $40 million jets.
Today's Navy. High-tech training that takes you only one way. Full speed ahead.
Primary's off.
Good job, guys.
You and the Navy.
Jeff?
See? He's not so little anymore.
Full speed ahead.
Ever since my brother Tom got this Magnavox 52-inch big-screen TV...
the show's gonna start. Come on.
He stopped going to the movies. The picture is huge, sharp, and brighter than any ordinary TV.
And I get great seats.
Plus, Magnavox has a 100-watt JBL sound system. It's the same Dolby surround sound you hear at the movies.
Yeah, and I don't have to stand in line in the rain anymore.
Tom, it doesn't always rain when you go to the movies.
Not anymore.
Magnavox. Smart choice. Very smart.
ABC's College Basketball, brought to you by Pontiac and your local Pontiac dealer. We build excitement. By U.S. Navy, you and the Navy, full speed ahead. By the United States Postal Service, we deliver for you. And by Nike, who reminds you to just do it.
We're ready to play basketball now with the Wildcats of Arizona, the neighboring state, coming into Las Vegas against the UNLV running Rebels. Arizona has never won a game here. And your starting lineups, the Arizona group that we've talked to you about, the front line, the backcourt, Matt Othick, who is a native son of Las Vegas, and Matt Muehlbach. Two very good backcourt people who can, Muehlbach in particular, hurt you from outside. For UNLV, their backcourt, Anderson Hunt on Thursday night against New Mexico State at the Big West Conference hit 8 three-pointers in the first half. Greg Anthony is playing with a broken jaw. He wanted to play with a hockey helmet and a face mask, but couldn't get everybody to agree on it, and so he's just playing with paper cross to protect his nose. Lute Olson, of course, And the keys for Arizona to win?
They must handle the pressure defensively because they know they're going to be pressured in the backcourt, and they must hit that perimeter jump shot because Vegas has such a dominant team on the inside. Lou Dolson, why is he so good-looking? I wish I had some of his look. And that's a look at Jerry Tarkanian. And the keys for UNLV, they're going to have to get their transition and layups to avoid playing against that matchup. And against the matchup defense, when Arizona sets up, Anderson Hunt, who's a very streaky shooter, Keith, must do what you said he did on Thursday, hit the three-point shot. He had 9 for 14 from three-point range in their blowout over New Mexico State.
There will be some rough stuff inside because both teams like to play physically inside. So let's see now what happens as we begin Arizona controlling the ball.
Interesting matchup, Lulock against Anthony.
Stokes is the freshman. That's Williams, who skated a little bit through the paint and gets called for the travel.
Williams has certainly been an enigma. He's been an up-and-down player. He's been a guy with a world of potential who has to start to develop. He said when he played for Maryland and Bob Wade that he didn't help to develop him. But if he wants to develop, it's going to be a two-way street. He has to learn to work.
Inside, Johnson has it blocked. Butler puts it up. A whistle stops him. Now you're going to see a diamond and a runner out here, or a spy, or whatever you want to call him, because it looks like it's going to be Muehlbach's chore to stay in the shadow of Anderson Hunt.
Well, if you can shut down Anderson Hunt from the perimeter, you make life very tough on the inside. As we look at the former Southwestern High School star from out of Detroit, Michigan.
Points of the game right there.
Special, no doubt about it. Larry Johnson, the great smile, the great upper body. If he were to decide to leave UNLV after this year, he would be automatically a top five selection in the NBA draft. And with that avalanche happening, with all those football players going early, Keith, I wouldn't doubt to see some college basketball players follow suit.
Yeah, but basketball started the whole thing.
Yeah, really? Well, they did after the Spencer Haywood situation.
They go inside to Williams, and Williams is mugged.
The
foul a moment ago was on Ed Stokes of Arizona, and this foul's going to go on Anderson Hunt.
They can't afford to lose Hunt because right now on their bench, Stacey Savanovic is injured also. He has a shoulder problem, a separated shoulder. You mentioned the injury to Anthony, but also Matt Osvick's playing with two bad ankles. Take a look at Matt Osvick.
Bishop Gorman High School here in Las Vegas at one time said he would come here but changed his mind. Matt Muehlbach.
What a solid player. His last five games, his assist to turnover ratio is 7-1, and that is sensational.
Score is tied at 2, early going at the Thomas and Mack Center in Las Vegas, where it's been raining and it's been cold. And out of the corner, the Anthony.
Greg Anthony, certainly a story, a guy of tremendous courage just to be able to be playing here with a compound fracture in terms of his jaw.
Happened in the game, the win over Fresno State. That was also the game in which Stacey Sionovich had a separated shoulder and David Butler sprained his knee. It was kind of rough, huh?
It was rough out there, they said. They lost all their players and had a tough game with Fresno.
Stokes, who's got a chance to be a star of the future right now, working against Larry Johnson. Ball knocked away from him and out of bounds.
They really like Stokes. They think he absolutely could be one of the real dominant players in Arizona basketball.
Good.
He can shoot the ball. As you said, he's a local kid who said no to Vegas.
Butler hurry. That's running rebel.
That's a great running game, Keith, of Jerry Tarkanian. Bring the ball in quickly after a score. Get it down into the boxes inside to the quickness of Butler.
Muehlbach loses it out of bounds.
He doesn't turn it over very often, and there's a look. I tell you, I envy this guy's looks, Keith. Look at those looks. If I had a chance to look like that, I might make it in television. And I tell you what, he coaches better than he looks.
Hot outside, Muehlbach on him. Ryan Williams working against Butler. Butler gets his shot off. It's off the back iron. And Buschler, who is a great leaper, Judd comes down with it.
Judd Buschler, one of the solid players in college basketball. Doesn't get a lot of recognition.
Goes to the sideline where it's retrieved by Anthony. Greg playing with that guard over his nose. And a beautiful pass down in the paint for the two.
Excellent pass, but tremendous transition basketball by Vegas. The trail man in the break, Johnson, communicates, calls for the open.
Oh, he just is incredible, Johnson, a way to run the court.
4-point lead for the Rebels at 9-5 and 17 minutes to go in the first half.
Stacy Ogman matching up on Buechler. Interesting matchup.
Stokes poked it away. Buechler trying to control it and can't. And it's Anthony, who with broken jaw and all, is right in the middle. And the lob is too high.
You know,
and
it's
two people down there reaching for it.
Anthony played in high school in the state championship game for Rancho High School. As we watch Anthony now, he's throwing the lob over the top. They both want the ball. They said, it's going to be mine. But nobody gets the rock. You know, in the high school state championship, they beat Bishop Gorman, who had Ryan Williams and also Matt Ostick on the team. Patience, poise on offense.
Rooks
Arizona.
Is in now. Sean Rooks. Box thought he was fouled, was, as a matter of fact, but no call. The officials are Gordon Burke, Norm Barucci, Bob Dibbler, work Big West, and Pac-10 games. Buechler is in the paint.
Excellent post position by Buechler to get free inside. Peel off the defensive player, show the hand to the baseline, tip the ball to the baseline side. The crowd is in it. They love it. This is a matchup. Arizona
leads. Tipped away, Rebels steal it. Ogman on the move, goes to Hunt, back to Ogman, and a whistle, and charging.
Offensive foul on Stacy Ogman. He's been the one guy in their lineup that has not given them consistent basketball. We take a look right there. There's the trailer. They love to run the trailer in transition. He's hanging. Hey, I'm not sure that defensive player is there.
Were square to the direction, though, and you don't have to have your feet set.
As long as you beat the guy to the ball. Stacy's one guy that hasn't given him consistent play along that baseline, especially offensively. And he's such a talent. He's multi-talented.
Rook, 6'11", in the ball game in a hurry.
He can score, Rook. He can score on the inside.
Crowd is very much into it as Anderson Hunt gets his second personal foul.
Anderson has to be careful to get the third. Jerry's going to have to make some decisions. They're very thin on that bench in terms of backcourt play.
15:50 to go, first half. UNLV leading it by six.
Are we on yet?
We on yet?
Jordan gets the ball. He drives down the left side of the fairway. Bo Jackson catches it at the wall and fires a bullet to McEnroe.
Yes.
Wow. Delectable. And now a word from our sponsor.
Nice shoes.
Rexy takes the puck up the ice and fires
the back end.
Out of the bunker. For a
home run.
Score.
Game, set, and touchdown.
Nice shoes.
And now, a word from our sponsor.
Holy cow!
Here comes Pontiac.
The engineers who created the Grand Prix endowed it with a fully independent suspension, a powerful fuel-injected V6, and made anti-lock brakes available. Its designers blessed it with an aerodynamic profile. And now, to make Grand Prix an even better value, our accountants have added this.
When you fly in United, you're probably not aware of the 60,000 professionals working to make your trip easy, or the way our new advanced terminals speed you on your way. Just as when you use the American Express card, you're not really thinking about all the services that make frequent business flyers rated best for travel and entertainment. You don't notice these things because they're there, but you would notice them if they weren't.
Arnold Palmer and Lee Trevino lead America's top seniors against an all-star international squad. The Chrysler Cup begins Saturday on ABC Sports.
Feel about
the Arizona Wildcats in the dark blue, homestanding running Rebels of UNLV in the white. And Ossick back in the ball game with Muehlbach at the guard position. Puts it up. Got it.
Nice touch by Ossick. They really believe he changed his mind about coming here and how much he loved Greg Anthony. He figured maybe I wouldn't get a whole lot of playing time with Anthony here.
Stacy Ogman over Buechler. And Buechler fouls him.
Bush was one of those kids I talked about earlier, underrated. You talk about fierce competitors. He's a member of my Mike Ditka team, a guy with intensity, a guy that really brings a lot of electricity to a team just by his work ethic.
Interesting that Brooks is in the ball game. He's been in Luke's doghouse a little bit, but he's in instead of Williams right now for Arizona.
Well, what makes Luke such an outstanding coach is we see Stacey Augman continuing to struggle. He has discipline with his basketball team. He sets the tone. You have to do it his way or you sit on a pine. And the bottom line with Rooks is very simple. Work hard in practice. Give me a tenacious effort every day in practice, and you'll get some PT, some playing time.
Arthur up against Anthony, and a whistle and a foul. Anthony
and Arthur went against each other, as we talked about, on a high school level. There's a look at his nose being bandaged. They say they're very concerned about the potential of him getting hit in the nose and have a broken nose, as you spoke to the doctor, and he told you a little bit earlier about a breathing problem.
Well, if you get whacked, he's got no way to breathe. He's starting to have to go into the trachea.
He's all wired up right now. His jaw will be wired for 6 weeks. He came right down on his chin, square on his chin, Monday night.
Brooks shoots over Johnson. Got it.
He can score, Keith. He's an excellent inside post player. He has excellent ability of how to get free down in the lane.
Big guy, boy. He stays a ton. He was 6'7", and he's in that 260 range.
It's an amazing transition this year as we look at them fighting for position inside. Lute Olson trying to work on the officials early. When I say transition, when you lose a Sean Elliott and lose a Cook, there's the big guy inside. What a strong move by Larry Johnson. And then Butler sliding to the ball. We saw this a little bit earlier in the game. There he is posted inside.
The Wildcats have cut the difference now to three as Anthony puts it up. Nice move by Anthony. He's bold. He's going right in there, injured and all. And he's in heavy traffic.
They didn't want him to practice yesterday, but he stood there. He practiced. He didn't want to come on off the court. Arizona's going to have to stop the inside play.
Everybody has to agree on his use of the helmet, though, including the opposing coach and the official. And they didn't get it. Rooks again. This time won't go down. A rebound is outside to Anthony. Hunt on a break. Can't get it to him.
Must stop the ball. See the trail man. There it is, the number five man. That's called the trailer, people. You trail, you get into the gut of the defense. Communicate is so key. Calling for the ball so the offensive player in front of you knows you're behind him.
7-point lead for the Rebels. Intercepted by Johnson inside, trying to force it.
Oh, bad play. Ooh, almost had the backcourt.
His feet hadn't touched. It was close.
You have to have both feet and the ball have to be across the midcourt line.
Over and back. Almost. Augman outside Anthony. Puts it up over Othick. Won't go down. Rebound. Rook. Othick all the way and doesn't get it.
Doesn't look like his ankles, though, are bothering him. He's had some strains of both ankles.
3-on-2.
That's what they do so well. Run, baby, run. They love it here in Vegas. I don't believe that Arizona could utilize the 94 feet up and down and beat Vegas in a running match. They're going to have more poise on offense.
Brooks inside, and he's fouled.
That's a good move. Little two-man play, Key. Dump the ball inside. They caught Johnson playing behind him defensively. Well, the soap opera continues here at UNLV. Another big major story today in the LA Times concerning alleged possible recruiting violations involving Anthony Jones. It just is one item after another, and that's why I say, and I told you last time, if Jerry Tarkanian has the opportunity to coach in the NBA, it will be bye-bye, sayonara from out at Vegas, because I think he's reached the point of total frustration. Big fella can score.
Yep. He's going to go out now, and Brian Williams is going to come back. I don't know. Jerry's licensed as an owner of a gambling enterprise in the state of Nevada. And he'd have to obviously give that up if he went to the NBA.
Oh, there's no question about that. They would not permit him, I don't think. I don't know all the particulars there, but I just know basketball, what his thinking process is, and I know he's totally frustrated, Keith.
Larry Johnson short with it. Rebound is outside the Muehlbach.
Muehlbach likes the big game. Solid fundamentally, always looking to make the good pass.
They take it back inside. Soft pass intended for Williams, and it's taken away again by the Rebels.
Oh, what a great running game.
Williams really hammered Butler.
I'll tell you one thing. David Butler has come to play. His quickness inside as he beat Williams to the ball created the opportunity for the transition. Now watch him up in gear. Stacey Augman kicks it out. It's run, baby, run. Now they flip the ball up on top, and there's Butler. There's the battle. They knock him.
If you're going to foul, do it that way. Don't let him have the basket. Make him make the free throw.
I'll tell you what I was impressed with yesterday. Watching them practice, the intensity they practice with. I know Pete Newell, who you think the world of, the Hall of Famer, University of California, great coach, won the national championship in 59, went to the finals in 60, won the Olympics in 60. He was so impressed yesterday talking about their work ethic. He said that is a credit to the man on that sideline, Jerry Tarkanian. Yep.
That's where it's done.
You talk about great coaches. Pete Newell was certainly one of the greats, and I know you know him well.
Known him a long time. Middle 50s.
He's now scouting for the Cavaliers.
Oh, lob inside. Did it.
Excellent pass over the top of the defense.
20 to 13 now. Stokes counts one.
He's got those long arms, Stokes. Came over from the weak side. We call it, when you define the weak side, Stokes came floating over. Ball side is usually the strong side. Weak side is the side away from the ball. Stokes rotated over from the weak side. See, they got an open play now to the strong side. There's Butler. Now watch the weak side. There comes the block shot, but he gets him with body. Ooh, I tell you, that was a great effort by Stokes.
Stokes had three blocks against Oklahoma in a period of 14 minutes, and that just sort of triggered him and set him off, and he's been slapping the shots aside ever since.
I'll tell you what, he earned some blame. You mentioned Oklahoma. What about next week? Missouri will be number one, and we have them going down to Oklahoma, where they've won. You ready for this? 43 in a row at home. The Cubs' living room. So Missouri should come in number one next week because they should beat Iowa State at home.
Johnson missed the rebound. Missouri at Columbia today. Beat Oklahoma 92-90.
That'll be a revenge matchup.
Brian Williams is hammered. No foul. Ball slapped out of there. Long pass down and run down by Muehlbach, and the Cats will bring it back.
No ball down there. I thought there was a little contact there. Really allow him banging. Not a good play offensively.
Nope, not a good pass.
He's got to give it up and get it back.
In front. Bad pass behind him.
The Butler should have given the ball a very sloppy pass in, Keith.
What by both teams. New Bushler.
Stopped in the middle of the lane.
That's the first point by Bushler, and the lead now is only six for UNLV.
Excellent decision by Bushler to pull up in the middle of the lane, look right and left, square your body, and shoot the little jumper.
Augman.
What hang time right there, little Michael Jordan, little acrobatic Stacey Augman with the move without the ball.
Womack is waiting to come in for Arizona.
They're playing Womack on the perimeter. When the season started and they beat Michigan, he was a baseline performer. Spacing 15 to 17 feet apart.
Three-pointer by Bushler won't go. Williams, the rebound.
I'll tell you what, he could be something special if he only would just say to himself, work, baby, work. Work, baby, work.
Augman got loose. Missed it. Got it again. Missed it.
What an effort. Three times. Struggling, shooting the ball. Augman with the quickness to the ball. Great effort by Stacey Augman. The crowd appreciates it, too. They give a standing ovation.
Lead is eight for the Rebels. 25-17 as Bushler is pinched in traffic and hammered.
You talk about hot teams, Keith. You look at the running Rebels now. They have won both their last 13, 18 out of 20. Their only loss was in that unbelievable game we had with LSU. Look at here. As the first, second, now he goes up the third time in a conversion.
Foul on Butler, timeout. UNLV 25, Arizona 17. Time remaining, first half and even, 10 minutes.
Thank you. prices beyond the reach of other overnight delivery companies, you'll find UPS. Because unlike the competition, only UPS Next Day Air guarantees delivery overnight to every single address coast to coast. And because we're so efficient, we can do it for up to half what other companies charge, whether the place is hard to reach or easy to reach. UPS. We run the tightest ship in the shipping business.
Look out tomorrow. Here comes Pontiac.
The road to excitement now leads to this. A special touring edition of the Grand Prix Sport Sedan. It's V6 power, fuel inject quick. It's optional anti-lock braking, sure and precise.
Look out tomorrow.
It's feel, undeniably Pontiac. Grand Prix STE.
Extra, extra, read all about it. Bowlers look for striking secrets at the Bowlers Journal Florida Open on ABC's Pro Bowlers Tour Saturday.
Okay, great screen by Larry Johnson. And right here, Stacy Ortman runs a curl move. And watch Brian Williams. See, Brian Williams has no vision in the ball of man. Breakdown by Williams right there allows Augman to get into the lane. Hang, you must see the ball in your man. A little tip for all you youngsters out there. Whenever you're playing defense away from the ball, you must see both.
Right now, UNLV winning the front line battle, 14-6. That's points in the paint.
With quickness inside, tempo, so important in a game like this.
Womack, number 30, is in there handling the ball right now. He's a leaper, he's a ranger, Muehlbach. Outside with him, and Muehlbach gets a shot off over Hunt. The rebound over Rooks and picked up for the Rebels, Anthony.
Defensive transition so important when you play against Vegas. The first priority is to stop the progress of the basketball.
Anderson Hunt, who lit him up here Thursday night with eight three-pointers in the first half alone. That's Butler.
Butler's got excellent quickness. He can play 15 feet away from the basket. On the NBA level, I project him as a second rounder, and basically he'd be a big forward.
The 10-point lead right now. Good pass along the baseline for Womack, and he slams it down.
Womack shows his quickness in moving without the basketball, one of the lost arts I often talk about. Most kids can move with the ball, but do not move well without it.
Barry Young is in, 33 for UNLV, and Anderson Hunt out of the corner for two.
He made that big shot to send home the number one seed last year, Arizona. I thought it was an offensive foul that he got away with, Steve.
A lot of people in Arizona agree with you.
Not too many in Vegas would, though.
Sean Rooks, big guy handling the ball. Butler hits him on the arm and fouls. That'll be a second personal foul. Technical foul on Greg Anthony. Greg Anthony came over and said something and made some contact with the official, and bingo, T.
Well, that's totally uncalled for. Jerry Tarkanian, certainly a communicator on the sideline, doesn't look at Greg Anthony, an entrepreneur.
He says anything else, he's going to be out of there.
The officials certainly trying to establish control. They had that ugly scene here in that Utah State game where it was just ugly, and it was certainly created by the punch by Chris Jeter, who got a three-game suspension. Like Tarkanian said, no doubt about it, Jeter started the fight.
Sean Rooks now with 5 points.
I thought he can't talk. What could he say with that wire talk?
I mean, he's been doing a lot of talking with a broken jaw.
Yeah.
I mean, that's a compound fracture.
He's all wired up. He probably thinks he couldn't talk to me yesterday.
Yeah, but he made contact. He kind of waved his arm, and I don't know whether it was intentional or not, but he actually touched the official, and that gets this automatic.
What a matter. Immediate.
Well, it was a 10-point lead. And then bingo, all of a sudden it's... could be as little as six.
That could certainly turn the whole complexion of a game around, especially if you capitalize and get a score here, Arizona.
Wildcats get the ball.
I think that UNLV, to me, Keith, when they have all their cylinders operating, they're playing also today without Travis Weiss, an excellent perimeter shooter who's got chicken pox. I think they're the best team in the country.
Bushler into the key. It's a 5-point difference now.
Judd Bushler, an excellent volleyball player as well.
And he wants to try his hand at basketball, see if he's drafted, see if he gets a chance to play, and if not, then he'll go on for the Olympics to try at volleyball. But he definitely wants to give basketball a run.
Well, you know, Arizona
is a little better than volleyball.
Well, I think the pay is pretty good. Hey, I'd like to be the commissioner. $10 million bonus? I tell you what, he deserves it. The best commissioner in all of sports, David Stern. That's almost as good as the bonus he gets during the year. They almost had the lob over the top. They're trying to clear out the weak side. They really exchange on the boxes inside.
Ball is stolen by Moses Curry.
He's been a terror, Keith. He's been a terror since he got suspended for the fight. Came back and was player of the week. Averaged 17 points a game off the bench and was the Big West player of the week.
And he just simply took that ball right away from Rooks.
He was very upset. He got booed a little bit in the North Carolina State game because they thought that he really was out of control in that fight. Look at that play right there.
Play by Womack.
Womack played high school with Stacy Austin, and it was a state championship together as teammates.
Butler? No. And a foul, Butler.
That's his third. That's a silly foul. I believe that's three for him.
It is. Three fouls.
That is an absolute silly foul by a senior, by a guy that you need across that front. David. You hurt the team in that situation.
Yeah. The over-the-back call is so automatic in basketball that, I don't know, you're entitled to play defense.
I can't find somebody's back there, Keith.
I wonder if he did, though. The guy in front was backing up.
I thought he made a poor play. I really did.
I don't question that. But the point is, your principle of verticality.
Oh, no. Verticality. I can't understand that. That's special verticality. That looks good in the record. That looks good in the rule book. Verticality. I knew you blew my mind.
Barry Young handling and foul. Hubach, first personal. Stokes has two for UNLV. Butler now with three and Hunt with two.
And a
timeout. 6:57 to go in the first half and a 5-point lead for the running Rebels.
What a job Lute Olson has done at Arizona. There's a look at Scurry. Up and away.
There's something coming. Transform like you never seen. Transform. It's a new kind of driving machine. Get on your Pontiac.
The space vehicle of the 90s.
Transform.
Introducing the Pontiac of minivans. The new Pontiac Transport.
Ride, transport, ride. Get on your Pontiac.
Hey, there's excitement.
Transport, transport, ride.
At BASF, we don't make the plane. We make it lighter. We don't make the lotion. We make it smoother. We don't make the dress. We make it brighter. We don't make the carpet. We make it tougher. At BASF, we don't make a lot of the products you buy. We make a lot of the products you buy better. BASF, the spirit of innovation.
Oh, the phone cords that bind, that hold your small business back. Now AT&T can set you free with the first cordless phone specifically designed for business, the multi-line Merlin Cordless. It works with AT&T small business phone systems, so you don't have to lose any quality to gain your freedom. Set your business free. Call 1-800-MERLIN-ATT for the new Merlin Cordless.
Missouri has restaked their claim to number one. Now they'll meet Oklahoma in a Big Eight battle. Or Indiana takes on Michigan State on ABC's College Basketball next Sunday.
31-26 ball game with the running Rebels leading. Time remaining to play in the first half, as you see. At one time it was 10 on its way to 12, and then bingo, here came that technical foul, personal foul, and then a basket after the possession. And that's turned it around for the moment.
Hey, Keith, you talk about Lute Olson. 7 years at Arizona, 154-59 against the Pac-10 since December of 1987. He's 51-5, and it's only going to get better. With Chris Mills eligible next year, they say he's been awesome in practice from out of Kentucky. Khalid Reeves, an outstanding scorer from New York City. Tony Clark. I mean, Lute Olson's got a class program.
Anderson Hunt gets into the foul circle and then gets chased out.
As Williams working inside defensively, trying to hold off on Johnson.
He's got a handful of Larry Johnson's shirt.
He's holding
him. He's got away with it. Rebound muscled up by Moses Curry. Gets the foul call. I mean, it is rough going. I mean, this is down dirty deep in the trenches in the paint right now.
He was holding. Look at him right there. That's a mugging. You can't get away with that. Blow the whistle. That's a mugging. Look at him. That's worse than New York Times Square. He's holding him.
No, it's not either.
No, it's not. I know you're having a ball here. You like it because so many football games are won in the trenches.
Yeah, big dude earning their supper.
Hey, Keith, Ryan Williams, if you watch the free throw, in the last six games, he's been 26-39, and he's really done an excellent job blocking shots, rebounding, and has been a solid performer. But he tried to cheat a little bit there defensively. He actually got away.
Williams rebounds it, and the Wildcats bring it up, trailing by six.
And Johnson trying to beat Williams to the ball, running him.
They got Scurry inside for the foul.
Scurry is a guy that is so enthusiastic and emotional on the floor. Look at next week, Missouri, Oklahoma, and then Indiana against Judd Heathcote's Michigan State, who's challenging Purdue. I got a heck of a game tomorrow night. Indiana and Purdue, if I could ever get to West Lafayette. You're going to help me out, Rock? You're going to help me out?
What about?
I'm going to have you travel with me one day.
I couldn't handle it. I'm too old for that.
You're young. Especially when you're on a golf course.
Really, the Rebels are right. Oh, my goodness. Oh. He put his elbow right in his sternum and knocked it flat. Got away with it. No call.
Johnson with the strength inside. Gets very deep. Best junior college player that I've ever laid eyes on. The last two great ones were Bob McAdoo and Spencer Hayward. Turnover.
Wildcats turned it over. Offic.
Chew that towel. Chew that towel, Tarp. What does coaching professionals do to coaches today? Except this guy. He stays. He's good looking. He belongs in Hollywood.
Lute is really hot right now over the call down here a moment ago when his guy was knocked down. And he is really hot.
Well, he should get a technical for being out of the coach's box. He's way out of the coach's box.
He also wanted his guy to come in the game, didn't he? And they didn't spot it.
See, Jerry's saying nail him with the tee. Jerry's 100% right. He's out of the coach's box. He's out of the coach's box. I tell you what, there's no love between these two guys in terms of their program. Now, take a look right here. Is there any doubt about that? Excellent defensive positioning. You don't blame Olson for being upset. You know, Jerry labeled them. Jerry writes a column in Vegas.
Yeah, but he was trying to get Rooks into the ballgame, wasn't he? And they didn't let him.
Look at Anthony running his mouth. He's got a wired jaw. He's looking at me and says, you're not supposed to be talking, Anthony. Look at him. He's trying to talk to him. He said, I chased out of here, Offic. Oh, he should be talking. Get a technical. Now they get the technical. Finally get the technical.
Jordan Burke walking over to Lute Olson.
Let me get back to the story. You know, Jerry Tarkanen writes a column. And in his column, he called Lute Midnight Lute. He said he strikes at midnight. He said we had Tom Colbert signed several years ago, and at the last minute, Arizona got him. And then he said we had Matt Offic committed, but he did it in a teasing way. And I think Lute got a little upset with it. But both these guys are winners. They both know how to win. And I'll tell you one thing. This guy right here, you can say what you want. His kids always play with intensity.
Maybe we need to build a house down at Searchlight and play on a neutral court. I'm going to Searchlight next time I'm over here. I've got to see a place named Searchlight. Moses Curry with Womack Airborne tried to find a hole and couldn't get there, but Hogman does, misses the shot, and the Rebels get it back. Here's this. Moses won't go down.
He really is tenacious on a board for the silly
foul. That's a foul on Curry.
The officials are going to have to tighten up a little bit. It's getting a little bit out of control on that floor.
24 to play in the first half. And coming up at halftime, we've got the Soviet basketball exchange between the young people of Louisiana, Baton Rouge area. They're going over as part of Glasnost. And a Foot Locker Slam Fest as Mike Powell.
He can really get up, I'll tell you that. He can really get up.
I think you should go over to Rotunda and do the Slam Fest.
That'd be nice.
Well, we used to do Superstars over there.
They pay me for it?
No.
Oh.
Give you free lunch, right? Anthony brings it up.
Anthony's played well, considering
the
fact...
Yeah, but look at him go into traffic here with that.
He's played
all banged up like that.
He's played well with a guy with a compound fracture of the jaw. He's got a lot more toughness than I possess.
9 points now.
All wired up. They're being wired up for 6 weeks.
Othick.
I'll tell you, Matt Othick, a little bit flashy initially in his career. Lou Olsen sat him down, and he said, look, when you leave your feet, you shoot the ball. When you're on the floor, you pass the ball. He was leaving his feet a lot, trying to make the flashy pass.
Oh, that was a ricochet.
Oh, a little bit of luck right there.
Give it to Johnson, dirty.
Closest guy.
No, give it to Augman.
Augman got it. These 4 minutes are big here at Arizona. They can't allow Vegas to get a spurt, and they're an excellent spurt team.
Back to 10 points now for the Rebels, and Buschner on the baseline is slapped and scored.
They really run the backdoor cut really well, Keith, and that is there because of the tremendous pressure defensively of overextending that Jerry Tarkanian teaches. Now here comes a little bit of a lucky hoop right here. Off the brick, Augman says, hey, I finally catch a break. I get the deuce. He definitely got his hand on it.
Well, right now, Jerry Tarkanian's concerned because Larry Johnson just picked up his second personal. Hunt has two. Butler has three.
Jerry's really concerned also. Needs this win for this reason. If they win here and they play Louisville next week at home and then blow away the people in the Big West, which they should, they can be 30-4. If they are, they will be the number one seed in the West. I don't believe they can afford another loss to stay in the top four and get the number one seed.
Anthony can't get it. Augman had his hands on it, but finally the Wildcats come out with it.
People probably say, why is the number one seed so important? Well, you get two games you should win as they watch you throw the ball over the top, turn over. You get two games you should win. That means you only have really two tough games in terms of going on to the Final Four. Not that the early rounds can't be tough, but you should beat the early team.
For all the packages you send, the urgent ones, the big ones, the small ones, you can depend on the U.S. Postal Service to get them there, when you want them, where you want them.
We deliver, we deliver. It's the reason you trust us. You know that we're going to come through for your postal service. We deliver for you. We deliver for you.
Sharp.
I like things made for me. Big.
Introducing Sharp Vision. Big screen TV perfected. All the excitement without all the drawbacks of other big screen systems. The portable projector is easy to set up. It zooms from 20 inches to 100 inches, so it fits any room and gives you a picture that's bright and clear from any angle with no adjustments. New Sharp Vision.
You don't just watch it, you live it.
To live the excitement, call 1-800-BE-SHARP. A breakthrough by Miller has produced Sharps, a non-alcoholic brew with real beer taste. Miller's Sharps lets beer drinkers keep their edge.
People who count on my breaks are important to me. So the people who work on my breaks are important to me.
The people who work on your breaks at Midas are trained brake experts. Remember, nobody beats Midas. Nobody.
Chrysler Cup Golf comes up next Saturday here on ABC Sports. The top names among the senior players. The U.S. against an international team. And then ABC's why that'll be followed by, on Sunday, Missouri, Oklahoma, Indiana at Michigan State. You want to check your local listings for the game in your area next Sunday.
And that big time. Well, here's a look at Ed O'Bannon, one of the top two recruits still available. O'Bannon from Artesia High School in Lakewood, California. unbelievable talent, they say. It could be Arizona State. It could be University of Southern Cal. I think Georgia's turning it around a little bit. If he gets lucky and gets O'Bannon to join Harold Miner.
Yeah, but who had the big week on the trip down south was the Golden Bears. Lou Campanelli goes down to beat UCLA and USC both.
I know, and Lou Olson's really concerned. He has a trip with Stanford and California coming up. Campanelli's done a great job, and Olson has the last game against against Oregon State at home, so that should be really, really interesting down the wire in the Pac-10.
I think California, with those two wins this past week, just put themselves in the tournament.
Well, they're number three. Yeah, I think they'll definitely be in the NCAA tournament. That was a mugging inside.
It's on Williams.
You scurry right to the deck.
You know, Moses milking it a little bit. He's getting up tenderly.
Looks a little bit like Tyson on a deck there. As the ball go down, he looks like a heavyweight Moses. I tell you what, look at him. He's got him in an arm lock. He throws him down. A little wrestling, a little Hulk Hogan.
There's a look at Brian Williams. Certainly has been a guy that came in with a world of expectations. ABC's Wide World of Sports on Saturday offers the one-day endurance event in the world. That's men and women swimming, cycling, and they're forcing the bodies through the Bud Light Ironman Triathlon World Championships. And Michaels will go back with a hockey team that produced their miracle in 1980. 4:30 Eastern, 3:30 Central on ABC's Wide World of Sports.
You know, Arizona State's got a real big edge in the recruiting of Ed O'Bannon. Bill Frieda is such a tenacious recruiter, but George McCorn, a former assistant here at Vegas, really is very close with O'Bannon's dad. That could be an edge. You never know.
Well, I don't know. I get a little tired of all this recruiting business, though. You know, that's a source of more trouble than anything else in college athletics.
But unfortunately, it is the key to success in college basketball. But that was one great drop step by Sean Rook. What a drop step inside. Catches the ball in a low post, spins into the lane. Watch this drop step to the lane. Okay, he fakes to the baseline. He hooks him with the right leg. Unbelievable drop step. I don't believe he walked. Some people thought possibly he walked. I thought he established his pivot foot. The left foot comes over.
Larry Johnson got his third foul.
That's big there. You know, Keith, you mentioned recruiting. I really believe in rating a coach. The key element, one, he has to be able to recruit. Two, motivate, communicate, and three, the technical strategy. If you can't recruit, and look at these teams here. There's some talent on that floor.
Yeah, but, you know, there's some con men. Phone rings at both ends. You got some con men that are shucking and getting all they can for whatever they can and for whatever the reason.
And some kids, too, know how to play the game.
Oh,
they know how to manipulate and use the coaches. It's a two-way street.
Turnover. You don't do what you're supposed to do. You should make an affirmative contract so that if they don't do it, then you can keep them out of the sport.
Big possession. Big possession right here.
I tell you, he's kept Anderson Hunt pretty quiet, hasn't he?
Yeah, he has. Really matched up well. And this kid here always makes the big play. Judd Bushler. Doesn't look pretty doing it, but just solid. Solid. We got a good one. These are two good basketball teams.
See, Hunt only scored one basket.
And it really matched up on him well.
Stacey Augman. Got it.
Stacey's a driving, slashing player. Not a good long-range shooter. Offic led his bid of form into the state championship as a senior. There he has played head-to-head against Anthony, who beat him for the state championship when he was a South, and Anthony was a senior at Rancho.
Forced that ball, and it is off the Wildcats.
He has a tendency to always want to make the sensational play off. He wants to be a little flashy, but on that sequence, I thought he made an excellent look. They just happened to deflect the ball.
Three-pointer, no.
That's not his range, Keith.
Stokes the rebound. Bad pass. Rebels get it.
Bad play by Stokes. The play wasn't fair. Really lost his poise.
James Jones, 34, is in there. He's another one that's got some size. Great leaper, 6'8", 6'9", 220.
Bushler comes up with that rebound, always around the ball.
Scurry's getting a lot of play time, isn't he?
Well, Scurry was player of the week last week. His performance off the bench averaged 17 points a game. He's rebounded in the Midwest.
Well, he has to put Johnson down because of three personal fouls. That's a bad shot by Rooks. He did it with an air ball.
Well, look who kept it alive. Look who kept it alive.
Stokes still in there.
Got away with one. Used the free arm. Used the free arm to get free inside. These guys are missing a lot of calls today.
Long arm, get a mighty push to get some daylight.
See, that's his game. Flash, drive, create contact.
Stacy Auckland, the Olympian. Womack coming back in for Arizona.
Watch this play here. Watch how Stokes now uses his free arm. Watch this right here. Bushler's going to take the little jumper now. Watch the offensive rebound. Now watch him use the free arm. I mean, he just threw him away. Threw him away with his right arm and utilizes the left arm for the layup.
Brian David, number 34, big guy, comes in for Arizona now. He's a fifth-year senior.
He's a role player, a complimentary player.
Well, he's in to take up space, bang the boards, and try to keep other people out of foul trouble.
Well, the one thing Lute Olson does well, as Augment's still struggling shooting the ball, Lute Olson does an excellent job defining roles for his players. They each have an option on the floor, and they know what their job is to do on the floor. And again, that's the sign of a good team. Gene Cady does a great job of that with Purdue.
5-point lead, UNLV. Judd Bushler getting a breather.
Gonna hold for the last shot.
Inside 20 seconds.
UNLV couldn't get the spurt when they were up 10 to break it open.
Hothick to David.
Here's the role player coming off. This is the big deuce, but created by the penetration of Hothick. His penetration broke the defenses down.
Anthony has it blocked by Rook.
Uncle Mo, a little momentum going in at halftime for Arizona after being down 10. Remember, Vegas trying to get that number one seed. Can't afford another L.
So it is UNLV 44, Arizona 41 at halftime. Only a 3-point lead at home, where they have won 101 of 107 games. Devon White, Mike Powell, and the Foot Locker Slam Fest coming up at halftime. And a feature piece from Cheryl Miller involving young people and a basketball exchange with the Soviet Union.
ABC's College Basketball, brought to you by Pontiac and your local Pontiac dealer. We build excitement. And by the Goodyear Tire and Rubber Company.
Why don't you love me like you used to do?
Commitment. What did she call the last 11 months?
My hair still curly and my eyes still blue.
That's the way she wants it. Hey, if she can go her way, we'll go our way. You know what I mean?
One day it could all come down to a few inches. For those few inches, it's good to know you have Goodyear tires.
You think someone's trying to tell us something up there?
That's why we say the best tires in the world have Goodyear written all over them.
She gets another shot.
This is the shop of Samsat Pazar, a thriving establishment on the outskirts of Bangkok. Unlike other international executives, he has no phone system, no computers, not even a fax machine. He does, however, enjoy one modern and efficient service nearly 4 billion people in 175 countries today can take for granted. UPS. We run the tightest ship in the shipping business.
Heard from an old student. Remember Brian McKenna? Smart kid.
Good ball player. Great hands.
Where's he going to college?
He's not.
Oh, too bad.
Studying aviation electronics.
But you said
in the Navy, then college.
The Navy College Fund. $25,000 for your college education. Today's high-tech Navy.
You and the Navy.
Like I said, smart kid.
Full speed ahead.
America, getting to know you is an experience you won't want to miss. America's funniest home videos, and I'm not just saying that.
Then.
He's never really been away from home before.
It's Elvis's first concert. Elvis, Sunday.
The untold story of the boy who became president.
You can tell all your grandchildren that you once went to bed with me.
The Kennedys of Massachusetts, starting tonight.
Yeah.
legendary dining at the El Dorado. Marianne's.
I'm Larry West, sales manager of Finley Subaru, 3112 East Fremont. Subaru Legacies are such fantastic cars, I wanted to tell you about them myself. We're having a sale now, the Top of the Hill sale. These Legacies won't last long because I've priced them equipped with 130 horsepower, four-wheel disc brake, automatic, air, AM-FM cassette, starting at $10,900. Now that's a bargain. Come into Finley Subaru today. Let's talk Subaru bargains.
We'll be at Gorman and Rancho High School's Operation Basketball Tuesday.
ABC's College Basketball Halftime Report. Brought to you by LA Gear. Unstoppable in performance fashion footwear.
Well, with all that's going on in the world, you are not going to have something happening unless it involves the game of basketball, because it is a game that's played all over the world. And there's our halftime score at the Shark Tank in Las Vegas. But let's spend a moment with Cheryl Miller as we take a look at the global aspects of basketball and young people who are using it to get to know each other better.
This week, a high school basketball team from the Soviet Union brought glasnost to the bayou. The spirit of freedom sweeping our world visited Louisiana. The Russian team completed the first Soviet-American high school basketball exchange that started with the U.S. team visiting Moscow in December.
I truly wish President Bush and Mikhail Gorbachev could walk two or three days in the shoes of these students. You know, to see these kids at these high schools, you know what I'm saying? Just to, you know, it's just total bedlam.
A visit to the Superdome in New Orleans. Blue jeans. Video games.
It's very difficult for a person who is coming and visiting the United States from the Soviet Union not to be excited about such a variety of goods you have here. We like it.
They played five games in 12 days. But took time out to learn about America. But some truths are universal, like who is the best player in the world.
Michael Jordan.
These young men have been treated like the stars they are. They will have plenty of gifts to take home. But it's what they've left behind that's most important.
What a hope for our world. You know, what a hope for the future. If these kids can get along like this, you know, imagine just if we could do it across the board.
The biggest problem with people is a lack of communication and getting to know someone. And it's hard to fight someone when you know them and you find out that they're friendly and you can enjoy each other's company. And once you find that a person is friendly, I think you can work with them. And once we're able to work together and join our two countries, I think it's going to be a great opportunity.
It is all be free, 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 free. It is all be free, 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 free. It is all be
ABC's College Basketball Halftime Report has been brought to you by LA Gear. Unstoppable in performance fashion footwear. Coming up next on the Foot Locker Slam Fest, two great athletes, second round action, Mike Powell and Devon White.
All of GM going all out for you.
There they are, the critics. I was just like them, talking cars, dreaming cars. Okay, so I still am. It's incredible. At GM, I work on a design. I think it's pretty neat. And one day, it's out where everyone can see it. Okay, be cool. Let's see what these guys think.
For 1990, GM offers American car buyers more new models than any other automaker in the world.
GM, the mark of excellence.
Those who have long enjoyed such privileges as we enjoy forget in time that men have died to win them.
Is what you're telling me that this city council is going to sit around on its hands while...
Peace now! Peace now! Peace now!
The freedom to say and think what we believe is ensured by this document. Join us in supporting the National Archives celebration of the 200th anniversary of the Bill of Rights.
My brother Tom used to flip me out. Every time I'd be watching a TV show I liked, he'd start flipping through the channels. Then we got this amazing Magnavox TV with a built-in smart window.
Smart window.
That lets Tommy flip through all the channels while I keep watching what I want to watch.
Now I can see what I've been missing.
And that's quite a lot.
Yeah, thank you.
Magnavox. Smart choice. Very smart.
Where did the Brooklyn High Five Flyers get the latest Nike basketball shoes? Size 16 to 8.5.
Where else are you going to go?
Where did the gum ringers of Normal, Illinois get Nike cross trainers for their entire family?
Where else are you going to go?
Golf's top seniors tee off in the Chrysler Cup. Then, bowling's best roll in for the Bowler's Journal Florida Open. And on ABC's Wide World of Sports, Dave Scott has worn this crown 6 times. Mark Allen has won every title but this. Now they meet in the most incredible duel this event has ever seen, the Bud Light Ironman Triathlon. And... Michaels looks at the Miracle on Ice 10 years later. It's all on ABC Sports Saturday.
Halftime, UNLV running Rebels leading the Arizona Wildcats by 3, 44-41. One of the big differences, bench scoring. 16-5 favors the Wildcats. Now we go to track and field and baseball for the participants this week in the Foot Locker Slam Fest.
This jumping jack is one of the premier long jumpers in the world and an Olympic silver medalist. This all-star outfielder not only has a golden glove, he also has steel wheels. Today, these two world-class athletes will compete in the Foot Locker Slam Fest. Along with Dick Vitale, I'm Roger Twybell. Deion Sanders has already qualified for the semis, and he'll face the winner of today's matchup, and it's a good one for you. Mike Powell against Devon White. Dick, you've been high on Powell since the beginning of this competition.
Roger, he's very flamboyant, he's creative, he's innovative with his dunks. He believes also that he can break the record in a long jump of Bob Beamon, 29 feet, 2.5 inches, and this is the reason why.
He took off near midcourt, and he knocks it down.
I'll tell you, he's a high riser, baby. He's an up and up and away man. He is an absolute flat elevator man.
And lots of tens by the crowd. He's a silver medalist at the 88 Olympics.
Oh, he deserves more than Bo Derek, baby. He deserves more than a 10. He should be an 11 man. Look at him go. Look at him pump the ball. What style, what grace. And then he points to the crowd. He says, do you love it?
Look at that hang time, Dick.
He's got great hang time. He's acrobatic. He's a three-ring circus man. You know, he's a walk-on here. He sent a film of his dunks to the committee asking them if he could join and be part of the whole show.
And you know, those track and field guys don't make a lot of money. He's after that $50,000, and he just nailed a 9.6. Devon White of the California Angels, and he's got 2 dunks to try to top Mike Powell's 9.6.
Roger, he's a defensive specialist. He's got a rifle for an arm, but he better have some legs. Oh, take a look at that one. That's a Roger, baby. That's a dunk that you have in your repertoire. That's a Twybell special.
Yeah, but I finished it off. I laid it in and went through the hoop.
Look at Will. Look at Will. He said, what should I give him? And there's Havlicek.
Those are the judges.
Earl Monroe. And look at Collins. Wake up, Big Dave. And there's Lanier. Come on. And Calvin Murphy. I couldn't screw up that team. I'd love to coach those guys.
Now, the second attempt for Devon White.
Oh, nice reverse dunk. that people realize. You got to throw it up. Look at the eye concentration. Great concentration and good hands.
Oh, and disappointment for Devon White as his 9.4 comes up short of the 9.6 Mike Powell had on his first dunk, and Powell moves into the semifinals, and Dick Vitale standing by with the Olympic long jumper.
You name all your dunks, you gave them to me. What was the name of the one you got the 9.6 on?
That was my Rockabye Baby.
Rockabye Baby. Are you going to win the gold?
I'm going for the gold, baby.
Next Sunday, two spectacular performers, wide receiver Chris Carter and outfielder Ken Griffey Jr.
You know we're gonna be there, don't think twice. Your service is part of our name. We're a part of your country, a part of your town, and no one else does it the same. We deliver, we deliver. It's the reason you trust us. You know that we're gonna love you. We're your most of service. We deliver for you.
Mom, we need more Wheaties.
Right now, get Michael Jordan posters free on boxes of Wheaties. Collect all three and turn them into one jumbo Jordan poster. But you better hurry, because they're going fast. Better get your posters. Better eat your Wheaties.
In a breakthrough that is sure to fill a growing demand among today's beer drinkers, Miller introduces Sharps, a non-alcoholic brew with real beer taste. Miller Sharps lets beer drinkers keep their edge.
Unstoppable. Unstoppable.
Tuesday.
Uh-oh, dueling grandpas.
Grandpas come home.
Anthony Romano?
Tony!
Hey! Who's the boss, then?
When did it happen?
Last night. Was it your dad?
He gave you the talk.
Kevin?
The Wonder Years Tuesday.
Wednesday, baby Chrissy goes back to the future.
I don't really love your daughter. But with a body like that, I'm gonna learn to.
Growing pains. Then, Uncle Sam wants Arvin.
The Cold War is back on.
War! War! No, I don't wanna go!
Head of the class following Growing Pains Wednesday.
The Gold Coast. The best foods for the best price anywhere. Take our words for it. Head for the Gold Coast Buffet. The last word in reasonably priced dining.
Hey, Vern. Oh. Just came in to cheer you up, and boy, do I have some great news for you.
Wilden's Pride Dodge Red Tag Sale is on now. Save thousands of dollars with over 250 new Dodge cars and trucks to choose from, with guaranteed rebates up to $2,500. And when you test drive any new Dodge, you'll receive $50. Them boys at Wilden's Pride Dodge are saving you money again.
Don't that sound great? Boy, Vern, you sure got awful emotional about good news.
We'll be at Gorman and Rancho High School's Operation Basketball Tuesday.
ABC's College Basketball, brought to you by the new generation of Oldsmobile. Step into the future now at your Oldsmobile dealer. And by UPS, for guaranteed overnight delivery from coast to coast. UPS runs the tightest ship in the shipping business.
Your halftime score. Teams are back now, looking ahead to the second half. I think the thing to simply dwell on here for a moment is the fact that it's close at halftime in a place where UNLV very seldom loses.
Well, Arizona shooting 59%, really doing well with their offensive efficiency. Vegas shooting 50%. Most clubs have not shot like that against Arizona. In fact, they're second in the nation in field goal percentage defensively, giving up 38% a game. Number one is Georgetown. But the difference, really, when you think about it, I thought was some absolute layups in transition that they got. Here's the first half story, Mr. Jackson.
Well, the front line of UNLV, you know, just hammered the board, too. And in particular, we had that couple of sequences with Squeery and Altman where they were getting two and three shots.
Well, they allowed them to really bang inside. Yep. I thought they missed some really pushing and shoving going on down the stretch.
Foul trouble is going to be a factor, though, and as we go to the second half. You've got Brian Williams for Arizona with three, but you got Butler and Johnson. See?
Butler and Johnson's three is certainly big. With Williams, they have enough in rotating big people inside with Sean Rooks, who could come off the bench and help on the interior.
Arizona got 16 points off its bench, whereas UNLV only got five. And as we start the second half of play, the whistles are blowing again.
Well, you know,
Nevada Las Vegas set the lineup for you. It's Altman, Anthony, Johnson, Butler, and Hunt, same group that started for Arizona. It's Muehlbach and Othick outside at the guards. Their front line consists of Williams, Stokes, and looking for the other big man. In and out, and rebound is Williams.
Good rebound by
Bushler
Williams.
Bushler is the other man, I guess.
Very quick to the ball. Yeah, Bushler is certainly a solid player. With the back Pac-10 player of the week. Had 36 points, 12 assists, 5 steals in the last two games against UCLA.
Good pass inside to Williams, but he can't get it.
He's really pressing scoring. He should be a much better scorer statistically than what he is. Altman takes it right at Williams, shoots it over the top. He's a driving player. He created that opportunity with a front change.
Well, Williams has missed two in a row, and they were not hard shots. 46-41, the Rebels.
Got to get a little more rotation for a better soft touch, but at least he shows he's a little active and wants the ball.
That's Altman. Good pass inside to Johnson.
The size of Williams inside created the miss by Larry Johnson. Little intimidation.
46-41.
Look at those numbers. 101-6. Wow. For the last 19 in a row. You talk about a home court, though. What about Arizona? 45 in a row at home. And Oklahoma with 43, who has a date next week for revenge against Missouri. We'll have it.
Butler gets it down despite the primal cry. Did Stokes get away with another one?
Yeah, he got a little push. You know, they're doing a great job. Both teams are jamming the ball inside, jamming it inside to their big people. And there's a lot of size on the floor. See, they're jamming it inside. Oh, he got hacked right
Butler
there.
Butler was fouled by Stokes, and no call.
Bushler had a good, strong first half, 4-for-8, and 5 rebounds. He's really challenging the defense. Oh, a little... laid it off to Williams.
Whoa. Brian Williams put a little axe on there and maybe got away with it, huh?
Looks a little tired, too. A little fatigued. He's going to go out. Yeah, Lute Olson recognizes a little bit fatigued. Takes him out of the game. His dad, who's entertained down here, sing with the platters. Little I'm sorry. Magic touch. I used to love those old Beasley goodies.
He was a musician. Did he play an instrument?
Grind it. Oh, look at that transition game. 3-on-1, finalized. Most teams like 60% ratio in conversion. Whenever you're going to go in transition, you want to score 6 out of 10 times.
Our 7-point lead now for the running Rebels. And your bodies are on the floor. Here comes Altman.
They're really going to the glass and pushing the ball out. Get a timeout, baby. Get a T.O., Luke. They're rocking and rolling. It's awesome now in Vegas. Get a T.O. Watch
Showtime right here.
Yeah, a little showtime. Larry Johnson. That's a horse, a thoroughbred, a Rolls Royster, a PTP-er.
Finally, it's a minivan for kids with parents. And let's face it, we all have them.
Yeah.
The all-new Oldsmobile Silhouette. Talking radical concept here. Your own window seat. Room for lots of things. And neat stuff to keep your parents from bugging you on long trips. Besides, Silhouette makes them look cool.
Right.
This is not your father's Oldsmobile.
Ready, dudes?
And they need all the help they can get.
Yeah.
This is the new generation of Oldsmobile.
Where did the Brooklyn High Five Flyers get the latest Nike basketball shoes? Size 16 to 8.5.
Where else you gonna go?
Where did the gum ringers of Normal, Illinois get Nike cross trainers for their entire family?
Where else you gonna go?
There were a few proud men, men of adventure, men of courage, men who knew the meaning of honor. There still are, the Marines. We're looking for a few good men.
Missouri has staked their claim to number one. Now they'll meet Oklahoma in a Big Eight battle. Or Indiana takes on Michigan State on ABC's College Basketball next Sunday.
We're going to show right now down inside how in this area here, they're going to get post position right down in this area. And they're going to swing the ball to the side to get the 45-degree angle on the entry down into the box. We're going to see them posted inside. They're going to try to get the ball over to Butler.
Now, listen, the sound of the game, use whatever tools you have.
There it is. Get him down the ball low inside.
Yeah, Butler. But the point was, Arthic was whipped, couldn't do anything about it, and came up with the primal yell and still didn't bother him.
Well, Arthic tried to bother him, coming over screaming and yelling, but the post position was excellent.
Three-pointer is short by Matt Arthic, takes it back in,
nice,
gives it away to Buschler.
Excellent look by Arthic. Great vision, spots the angle cut by Buschler, and dumps it off for the layup.
7-point difference now in the ball game. 52 for the Rebels and 45 for the Wildcats.
Every time UNLV's come out with a spurt, Arizona's had an answer. Here it is.
Stolen. Hubach never quite got the kind of control of the ball he needed to effectively get it across court. Takes it into Stokes here. Won't go down the tip by Buschler twice. And finally, Anthony. Broken jaw and all comes out of there with it.
Anthony had a solid first half. It really closed the door on Anderson Hunt, who had 31 in that blowout against New Mexico State, where they were really spent emotionally. Had a great first half. They were up 62-39.
Stokes whistle for the foul. That will be his third. They've had a hold of Larry Johnson's shirt inside. You can take that thing and stretch it over the semi-truck the way they've been stretching it today.
They've been holding and clawing and grabbing. See, they're getting the ball in too deep.
Yep, Butler.
Getting the ball in too deep, Keith. That's a no-no defensively. They got to get into board denial, three-quarter, and get some help. Three-quarter defensively simply means try to beat them to the ball. Don't allow them to get the ball in that low. Not a good pass.
Got themselves in a pickle right there. Got trapped and threw it away.
Not a good pass by Arthur. What a great pass that was, though. Anthony, where does he get the vision? Ball bandaged up. Jerry's got to like the unselfish play of the running Rebels.
11-point lead, the biggest of the ball game for UNLV. Rolls left out of there by Butler.
David Butler says, don't bring it in here, big fella. UNLV for years has dominated with their defensive play. There's a look at the agility and the mobility of David Butler with help defensively.
I mean, Shark Tank is rocking right now. 56-45.
And they're really locking up pressure in the ball.
Bushler takes it in there. Finally, it's tipped in by Stokes.
Stokes hanging around the basket with the tip. His dad is an orthopedic surgeon. Stokes, great family.
Ed's got a bright future in front of him. It's Hunt. Won't go down. Over the top. Out of bounds.
I really believe next year you're going to see Arizona up there in the polls. I mean, Chris Mills is not an average player, Keith. That is a star player. As Jerry wants to try and get a timeout in the next possession.
Bushler.
Judge Bushler, always making the big play, yeah, and always showing guts coming back. Down 11, they're back in it again.
I think Jerry sensed it coming. Now he wants the timeout. He wants to talk to his people because they had him 11 down, and now, boom, boom, it's only 7. And you've got 14-16 to play in the ball game.
You got to think about making a living.
Well, didn't you ever want to be a baseball player?
Well, sure. Everybody has that dream.
It's not a dream.
A lot of competition out there, son.
One day, it could all come down to a few inches. For those few inches, it's good to know you have Goodyear tires.
Of course. I'd be proud to have a ball player for a son.
That's why we say the best tires in the world have Goodyear written all over them.
Announcing three ways Oldsmobile's owner satisfaction plan gives you a big edge. One, if you don't still love your new Olds after 30 days or 1,500 miles, we'll let you do something no one else does. Return it. Two, unlike some warranties, Olds covers just one part. This is the part. Three, Olds now offers roadside assistance at a very convenient time. Around the clock. The Oldsmobile Edge. Extra satisfaction at no extra cost.
This is the new generation of Olds.
One dry is brewed longer. One dry is brewed from the most expensive ingredients. One dry refreshes completely. One taste, and you'll know why. The one dry is Michelob.
Ready. The time is right for the Bud Light Ironman Triathlon. Plus a special look back at the Miracle on Ice. All on ABC's Wide World of Sports Saturday.
He 56-49, 14 minutes, 16 seconds left. Right now, Arizona for the year has not allowed a team to shoot 50% or more. Today, UNLV shooting 54%. I told you earlier, the opponents are shooting 38% against UNLV, against Arizona. But there's the dish by Anthony, and it's this transition in layups in transition, the reason that Vegas is shooting 54%. Hey, anytime you're holding the opposition all year under 40%, you always have a chance to win. And that's what usually makes Georgetown so special.
All right, now, you've got 56-49 lead for UNLV. They have the ball here as Johnson gets it inside and gets in the basket. But Anderson Hunt has only scored one field goal at 8:55 to go in the first half. But by having the ball taken away by Anthony, he just simply took it away from Osick and scored it. That's the second time the Rebels have done that. But in committing themselves to a diamond or whatever they've chosen to play here and really taking Hunt out of the ball game, they simply opened up the middle. The other people are just killing them.
Well, I've done a great job matching up on Hunt, but the inside people have dominated that they haven't needed Hunt. That's a strong move inside.
Ed Stokes.
Greg Anthony's got such quick hands. He picked the pocket a little bit earlier of Osick.
Butler over Stokes, and Stokes fouls it.
See, they're able to get the ball inside right now very effectively, so they're not relying on a perimeter game. And that's the balance I talked about a little bit earlier as we look at the concern of Lute Olson.
Ed Stokes has four fouls. That's what he's upset about.
I think Jerry Tarkanian has the best starting five in the nation. They have all the answers. They have legitimate point guard play with Anthony. They have long-range shooting in Hunt. They have inside power play with Larry Johnson. They have wing play with Stacey Augment. In fact, when you look at Georgetown, one of the negatives, they don't get any scoring at all out of the number three position, the small forward position. And I believe that's a vital position. And there's a look. She's praying. Look at her praying. Oh, Lois, this is hoops, baby. This isn't war. This, look at her. She's praying, Jerry. Jerry, she's praying for Jerry, Keith.
I can't believe she gained so much at a game.
Can't be fun if you got to sit there like that. It cannot be fun.
Lead is back to 11 now for the Rebels.
Your analysis on that, Mr. Jackson?
I don't have it. Pass inside. Good strong move by Rooks. Won't go down.
Well, Johnson. Oh, no, they got Butler. Well, either one. Take your choice. It's four, and either Butler or Johnson.
Either Butler says, they got me. Larry says, yeah, they got you. They didn't get me. Look, he says, they got you, David. Raise your hand.
I don't want the fourth. Raise your hand. Come on, David. Go to the sideline. Sit on the pine. Yeah, you got four, David. I play.
Curry comes in.
See how guys try to con? He don't want to go out of the game. You think Johnson lets us sit down? He says, Butler, you sit down. That's Stacey Sianovich talking to him. He's got a separated shoulder.
Well, it can't be too bad because he played here Thursday night.
Yeah, he said it really pained him, though. He did not practice yesterday.
Right. Separated shoulder can be a lot of hurt.
Hey, you know, talking about Arizona, again, having a great year. I read recently, Brian Ryder of the L.A. Times, Alan Malamud picked his all-Pac-10 team. It went Peyton Miner, it went Trevor Wilson, Don McLean, and Adam Keefe. Not one Arizona player yet, to me, when it's all said and done, they're going to win the Pac-10.
Hunt having a tough day.
They can't hear us up in Corvallis, can they? Oh, nice look inside.
They're in today playing, and there's a foul on Rooks.
But what a pass inside. And then I love the emotion of Moses Scurry. He goes bananas, little high five. Larry says, get me the rock.
Larry Johnson, 15 points.
A very quiet 15, Keith. There he is, number four. He wants the ball. Yeah. And there's the dump down inside.
This is look how strong he is, though. That takes strength.
Oh, he's got great strength. If you look at that body, it's so impressive. He was a star for Team Katie when they won the gold medal in West Germany, the World University Games team. Team Katie just praises him to the tilts. He's what a great guy to coach.
12-point lead. Anthony made it.
Anthony is dominating on the perimeter defensively.
He is picked off the pocket three times now.
And then he finishes it off. Justice comes to the guy that made it initially with the defensive play. Greg Anthony, look at him now, he's getting the crowd all fired up. They have an outstanding team, baby.
15-point lead for UNLV at 12:25 to go, and the Shark Tank is rocking.
There's
back
trouble.
After this message and a word from our ABC station.
Finally, is a minivan for kids with parents. And let's face it, we all have them.
Yeah.
The all-new Oldsmobile Silhouette. Talking radical concept here. Your own window seat. Room for lots of things. And neat stuff to keep your parents from bugging you on long trips. Besides, Silhouette makes them look cool.
Right.
This is not your father's Oldsmobile.
Ready, dudes?
And they need all the help they can get.
Yeah.
This is the new generation of Oldsmobile.
This is ABC. All you can eat at the Circus Circus Dinner Buffet. Four fast serving lines and 45 different items. This and more, only $3.89.
I got caught in a love triangle, looked at Taco Bell. When I tried that new steak taco with a salt tortilla, yeah. And then I took a bite of the new chicken taco and it stole my heart as well. And I was already in love with a 59 cent taco with a crunchy shell. Now I'm caught in a love triangle up at Taco Bell. I better run for the border.
My show from Las Vegas, all this week on Channel 13.
There's one of the the big games today. That was at Columbia, and Smith got in foul trouble early on in that ball game, and it was really, really close.
Right? Well, he made a big three-point, but look at Ohio State. Jimmy Jackson beats the Wolverines. They need some help tomorrow from the Hoosiers against Purdue. Texas wins. Rutgers gets beat again. Temple. Mark Makin's had a tough time shooting the ball this year, under 40%.
Arizona in the dark uniform. That's Matt Muehlbach for three.
He's really been stroking the three lately.
That whittles it down a little bit. It goes from 15 down to 12 in a hurry.
Well, the defensive pressure of UNLV, they play good perimeter defense and don't allow you to square up and shoot the three.
Anderson Hunt.
Not a good shot by Hunt, but why?
Larry Johnson.
Doesn't matter when you got Larry Johnson hanging around the basket. The best junior college player I have laid eyes on.
That's Judd Bushler. And Othick for three, no. Rebound Johnson.
UNLV is just such an outstanding team defensively. And they look so much better today than what they did earlier in the year when we saw them. They got all their horses now. He's coming against LSU. Stacey Ortman didn't play.
Play inside by Muehlbach. And as a whistle and a foul on Anderson Hunt, that's three on Hunt. Time remaining now, 11:09. Hunt has three. Butler four. He's on the bench. Johnson three. Check your local listing for the game in your area.
It'll be number one Missouri. They'll beat Iowa State at home, and then they go down and play at Oklahoma, who has a 43-game home streak. And then you got Indiana, the Generals Club, going against Judd Heitkel, one of the surprise teams in America, Michigan State.
They can fill it up on those three corners, can't they?
Oh, Kirk Manns and Smith are outstanding backcourt combination.
Womack is fouled by Anthony.
Look at Anthony. He knows he had the great game. He knows today's been his day. He knows he's been the star. He's getting a lot of ink. He's got another year yet. Transfer from the University of Portland, where he's the freshman of the year. There he is. Look at him athletically. He tries to bait him into that position. Womack's going to be an excellent player. He's got good quickness.
Yep. And he's not afraid. He goes right in amongst the trees.
Pac-10 has really picked it up a notch. You mentioned earlier Luke Campanelli's team, California, certainly now in third place. UCLA gives them four solid clubs with Oregon State and Arizona. And USC, think about them. They've won three of their last five and have improved. Lost a tough one yesterday.
All they got to do is keep their people at home. I mean, they have people running off to Syracuse, Kentucky, and all those kind of places. Well, you know, all they need to do is keep their people at home. There's plenty of basketball players out in the West Coast.
They got a few players out there that are left and headed elsewhere. They like that nice snow and ice.
Yeah, sure. You bet.
I want to get away from that sunshine.
Muehlbach over Hunt.
He can shoot it. Doesn't shoot enough. He's got excellent touch.
Back to 10 now.
I'll tell you what. There isn't quit on the jersey of an Arizona player.
And Stokes is back in for Arizona. Four fouls on him. And that's number five right there.
He's bye-bye. He's too strong. Johnson's too strong for Stokes right now. He's learning and will be ultimately a very good player. Lucia Fighter on that sideline. Did a great job at Iowa. Johnson holding him off right here. Seals him off with the left arm. Actually with the right arm, and he gets the ball thrown to the left hand. Look at the body of Johnson.
Is that a foul?
We'll talk about the job that he did at Iowa. Iowa got beat by 47 yesterday by Indiana. 47. They got to really improve their recruiting, Keith. They don't have enough athletes to give them the kind of basketball that they had the last 3 years with Marble, Armstrong, and Horton. Look at Johnson. He wants it down in the box.
Ryan Williams is in there now against him. And stepped out of bounds.
I'll tell you one thing. Really loved him yesterday, watching him at practice, now with the Cavaliers.
Womack goes to Rooks. Got it.
He knows how to score. Sean Rooks knows how to score. Per minute, if you look at his totals, they're really impressive.
Now 8-point lead. So the Wildcats back into the game at 9.5 to go. This is Hunt. Oh, good move.
Anderson Hunt with a little penetration. He's been quiet today.
That's the first bucket since 8:55 of the first half.
And he has 31 against New Mexico State. Neil McCarthy's team certainly should have surprised.
They had a big win yesterday.
New Mexico State, Jerry felt that they played the best first half in many of the year. They were up 62-39 and had this place rocking. I guess Neil McCarthy's team, certainly one of the surprises, as I said a little bit earlier, beat Fullerton State last night.
Brooks is short with it.
That's out of his range. He's got to get down in the boxes a little bit more.
Hunt fires it up.
He can do that. And nine of them.
There's the rebound.
We've had a big game against Southern Cal.
They call Buschler for the foul.
Anthony does a great job stepping in on Buschler. Good Buschler, tenacious, competitor. Take a look right here. I'll tell you, Buschler ran him over, no doubt about it, but some people would say that's a no call. I think he ran him over. I think he got to blow the whistle there. My producer's debating with me. He says no. The fine Kenny Wolf, former Harvard jump shooter.
Larry Johnson's going to take a breather now, and they're going to risk Butler with four personals back into the ballgame.
Well, see, they flip-flop. They know Johnson's got three. They can take him out and rest him a little bit. It's pretty nice if Butler gets five that you go to the bench and bring in a Johnson.
So Stokes leaves.
Arcadian is crafty on that sideline. He knows his trade and well. Look at that high-low execution. Look at Bowman. Look at him erupt. Look at him erupt. This guy's a, he looks like Spinks. He looks like Leon Spinks. Look at him. He looks like the heavyweight champ of years ago. Leon. Peter Johnson. That's my man, Moses. Look at him. They're laughing. They love it.
Brooks has three personals now for Arizona.
That's
74-62.
Keith, that's the high-low entry. Ball up in the high post. You dump it down to the low post. 15 feet apart. Good cut without the ball.
Brooks comes out of there with it. Leaves it for Muehlbach.
Story's been a consistent performer off the bench the last month.
Womack to Brooks. Foul Anthony.
He's got that smile on. I'll tell you what, he absolutely knows he's been sensational today. Greg Anthony.
Great person.
You know, he's heard a lot of talk about maybe they should have brought in Matt Hothick here, who's from Vegas, who committed verbally and then decided to go at the last moment to Arizona.
Well, he didn't want to camp behind Anthony.
He'd have to sit behind him a little bit. I'll tell you what, though, Hothick, as good as he is, you'd find some playing time for him. Those kids want PT. They want playing time. Look at these numbers. In limited climb coming off the bench. He's been doing this all year long. He's really the strongest inside player offensively down in the boxes. Plays 20 minutes a game, and like averaging 10 points a game.
Williams and Buschler both had a tip at it and couldn't get it in.
He had 24. He had 24 against UCLA.
Talking about Rooks. This is Young dribbling the ball, number 33.
I don't want to cheat him. He's averaging 11.9. That's it. Got to be exact. Run Rooks. They're trying to match up on Hunt. They know Hunt likes to score.
Rebound, Brian Williams.
Williams doing a good job defensively rebounding.
Yep.
Good position by Williams.
Yeah, he's played tough today. Muehlbach.
I'll tell you, Muehlbach, a steady player. You know, consistent. Reminds me of a version of Steve Kerr. Remember Kerr two years ago now playing with the Cavaliers? Kerr was money.
Really got it inside to Scurry. Scurry tries to give it. The Cats knock it out of bounds, and the difference in the game is again on the 8 points.
With 7 minutes to go, and a guy that can shoot the three like Muehlbach, you got a chance.
Johnson's going to come back with Augman now.
I'll tell you, Vegas leads the nation in high fives. They lead the nation in high fives. Yeah, give a couple more. Come on. Hey, Scurry, he looks like a heavyweight champ. You ought to get him to fight that Buster guy, huh? You ought to get him to fight Buster.
No.
I want to be his manager, get
10%. No.
The money they're laying out.
No. I don't think Moses wants to do that. Buster's pretty good.
I tell you what, he deserves that championship. He flat out beat
Tyson, wire to wire, no doubt about it. The worst beating since Robin Gibbons took on the floor.
Johnson is fouled by Rooks, and that's four.
Johnson is such a driver. There's a lot of talking going on here. Rooks says he's not going to back away. There's the slashing, driving ability, strength, power. Takes it to the goal. And there's Rooks. See, hangs in the air. It's that little contact by hanging in the air. Rooks says, no way.
Well, Arizona has lost Stokes. Williams has three, Bushler three, and now Rooks four.
That was a tough call, KJ. Tough call.
Yep.
You like this guy? You gotta like this guy.
Yep.
What a great personality, too.
It's just, I like him, just the whole thing about him. He just
loves playing.
Terrific kid, yeah.
Yeah, has a passion and a feel for playing. And I love people that have that kind of feel and that kind of emotion. That's Mrs. Tarkanian.
19 points now for Larry Johnson. Hart. Here's Muehlbach now with Anderson Hunt on him. He's got a little size advantage on Hunt. Bushler. Oh, Johnson got away with one. No call there. They go inside to Rooks. He reels inside, and Johnson got him, I think.
He really knows how to score, Sean Rooks. He really knows how to score. Do you know that in Christmas time, Keith, he was talking about transferring because he was unhappy with his playing time?
Johnson didn't get it. It's Young.
I got lucky it was on Young. But Rooks finally got himself some playing time and really is a force.
Watch this.
Yeah, Johnson should have had one. Here's the pump. There's right one. There. Come on, right in front of the official. Blow the whistle. Blow the whistle.
Anthony comes back and Barry Young goes out.
Young is a guy that's got range as a shooter. Timmy Gergovich, one of the fine assistants in America. Jerry delegates a lot of responsibility. He was a former head coach at Pittsburgh who's turned down a number of head coaching opportunities.
Well, he likes to coach, and you can't always just coach when you're the head man. You got to do some politicking and whatever else goes with it.
Oh, today, the pressure's unbelievable. I mean, you get kids today, if you yell a little bit at them, they call a meeting and there's a boycott, okay. Yep. And they try to run you out of coaching. I mean, it's incredible. They ruin people's lives. I mean, I mean, getting yelled at and screamed at, I think sometimes it's inhumane treatment by the players who don't perform and get the coaches fired. What about tickle the twine? And, you know, they say coaches don't communicate. They communicate really well when you're tickling the twine and not hitting the rim and creating Brick City, USA.
David is back in, number 34. He's the big fellow that had a basket at the close of the half. It's 75-68, 7-point lead, UNLV, 6:40 to go. The Wildcats are not going away.
They can't knock them out. They can't flat out knock them out. They missed Butler. Too late, they got him the ball right there. Timing is so important when a guy posts inside. Arizona trying to give a lot of help defensively. See, there's the inside-outside action. Once you get it into the post, people. Look at the quickness of Butler.
Butler's fouled by Williams. That's four on him.
What makes them so effective along the baseline, Vegas, and I've said from day one, they're the best run court in basketball. Michigan has a great one when they get Sean Higgins back with Vaught and also Terry Mills. But they're so quick, the Vegas kids, and they know how to drive with the ball down inside. This big, tough guy can score inside.
They'll take Williams out now and send Rooks back.
Well, they rotate the three big fellas, Williams, Stokes, and Rooks. Stokes is gone for the day.
2-4 Butler.
Academically ineligible earlier in the year. They missed Butler. They also missed Scurry coming off the bench. There's Clark getting ready to chew that towel. I've said time and look at what coaches, what it does to them. Chewing towels, 59 years of age. Incredible. I can't complain, Keith. I was probably the worst wacko in the game on the sideline. You never saw me. I was absolutely bananas.
Yeah, I did.
I was bananas. Now I'm a very calm, cool guy, very low-key. Whoa. Look at Bushler. Good move along the baseline. Hanging in the air. Tough.
Long pass. Too long for Altman.
Not a good play. Trying to make some spectacular play. Don't need it right now. They're only up 7 with 5 minutes to go. This is a big golden opportunity right now for Arizona.
Muehlbach got the ball with Hunt coming out to get it.
They got
to
watch him with the three-point shot. And Rooks down inside. I'd go to Rooks. Oh, come on.
Well, Butler hit it, and then he couldn't get a hold of it, and they lose it.
Big possession.
Yep.
Got to try to get some motion now on offense.
Yep.
Could be a four-point turnaround. Could go up to 9 instead of 5. And that's without the 3. See, they're getting a little motion. Pass and go away. Pass, Hunt goes away, replace, exchange on the boxes inside with Butler and Johnson.
They got David on Johnson right now. David can't handle him.
They're going to try to isolate Johnson one-on-one, or they're going to go to Butler. They're using the clock. There's a screen. I'll slide inside. No, he should have slid inside Johnson.
Three-pointer.
I mean, that's amazing. That is amazing. We know about the strength and power game, but he completes it with perimeter skill as well. Without a doubt, he's a top 5 selection in the NBA draft if he comes out this year. And there's a lot of talk he may, even though he says no way.
Womack misses. Rebels run it. Hoffman's cake. Traveling.
Violation. I think a lot's going to be determined by what happens to Jerry Tarkanian in terms of the NCAA investigation that's been going on for 2.5 years. Also, the fact there's a pro job come his way. I think all of those factors will weigh in the decision for Larry Johnson.
Eubach, good move. Monko, rebound, Bushler.
Hey, what a play by Bushler. I'll tell you something. I talked about it earlier. My good friend Alan Malama does his all Pac-10 team. It doesn't have one Arizona player. It's going to be pretty tough to keep this guy off an all Pac-10 team. Chad Bushler, look at him working inside. Great effort. And watch the second effort by Bushler, a volleyball player.
Butler's gone. That's 5 personal fouls on David Butler.
And Scurry becomes big now. He'll have to come off the bench and give him some positive moments.
Brian Williams is going to come back.
Last year, Arizona was number 1 seed in the West. They got beat on that controversial jump shot as Butler goes out with 19 big points inside.
Womack is out, and David is out. Offick and Williams come back for the Wildcats.
I said O'Bannon sitting right behind the bench in that gray shirt, one of America's outstanding players in high school, a scholastic super from out of Lakewood, California, rated by all the so-called scouting gurus as one of the 5 best in the United States. Williams with 4 could get 5 if they dump it down into Johnson. Playing a forearm across his back.
7-point lead for UNLV.
See, right now, Johnson's going in down deep. They missed him. They're trying to use some clock. Williams got to see ball in man now from that help position.
Williams with 4 personal.
Yeah, that's why they should go right to Johnson. He's got 4. They got to go right to Johnson. Take it right at him. There it is. A moment ago, people, you saw him shoot a 3-pointer. Now he goes down inside and demonstrates intelligent basketball instincts, knowing that Williams has 4. Takes it right at his face.
Inside Williams' left hand. Won't go down for Brian and Anthony. Sweeps it off at 3. 20 to go and a 9-point lead for UNLV.
Running Rebels win today, Keith. They're going to rip off the rest of the season. They'll beat Louisville here at home and nobody in the Big West, as it's all Running Rebels in terms of the Big West. They just dominate the conference.
Well, it'll be 22-4 overall. Arizona, if they lose, will be dropped to 17-5. All of the losses have been on the road. Hunt.
Look at Johnson. He's a man. Hello. M-A-N.
Hunt's hurt.
Well, they can't afford to lose him for the season. That's been the problem here at UNLV. Injuries, distractions.
Holding his hand in the areas of his groin area.
Looks in pain.
Yeah, he is in pain.
I'm not a doctor, so I can't tell the severity, that's for sure, from the sideline, but he does look in pain. Played for Perry Carter down at Southwestern High School. There's the drive by Hunt. Picks it up. Gets knocked to the deck. Look at Johnson.
Man.
M-A-N. I even could spell that, and I'm a dummy.
B.F. Goodrich TA Tires perform like great athletic shoes. They grab. They dig.
B.F. Goodrich TA Tires.
B.F. Goodrich TA Tires, the athletic shoes for your car.
B.F. Goodrich TA Tires.
To us at UPS, this is a custom car. Why, this beauty's been modified dozens of times. It has a fiberglass fuel-efficient front, a rapid-opening foam-filled door, and a sunroof, all of which makes us more efficient, so we can deliver next-day air for up to half what other companies charge, and allow our drivers to be seen in one mean set of wheels. UPS, we run the tightest ship in the shipping business.
Finalease is a minivan for kids with parents. And let's face it, we all have them.
Yeah.
The all-new Oldsmobile Silhouette. Talking radical concept here. Your own window seat. Room for lots of things. And neat stuff to keep your parents from bugging you on long trips. Besides, Silhouette makes them look cool.
Right.
This is not your father's Oldsmobile.
Ready, dude?
And they need all the help they can get.
Yeah.
This is the new generation of Oldsmobile.
Larry Johnson has taken over the ball game. He's keeping UNLV on top of Arizona. And Dick Vitale, were you right?
Well, you know, every time, Keith, they made a run. You take a look here, Arizona keys to win. They must handle the pressure D. 16 turnovers, and they've had 17 points off those turnovers. But the answer is no there. Must hit the perimeter jump shot. Really haven't hit it consistently. Muehlbach hit a couple, but not a host of them, which would have helped them inside. So the answer there is no. They got to get some transition off their layups in transition. They have 18 points off fast breaks. Hunt must have a big game. I wasn't dead. I think you handled that one there. Didn't you provide that for our producer, Kenny Wolf? No, I was wrong there. I thought Hunt would have to have a big game here. 3 out of 4, though. That's a good grade. That's a B.
Yeah.
I had an A-plus last week.
You won't get a raise, though.
So an A-plus and a B. I've got an A-minus for the last 2 weeks. Not bad. Semester grade. There's a look at Jerry D'Artagnan on the sideline. Hey, Anderson Hunt, he looks like he's going to be okay on the sideline. He played for Perry Watson, a great young coach from out of Detroit. In fact, Jerry D'Artagnan, very high on him. But if he had an opening on his staff, he would certainly consider him. Very impressed with him. Hey, what about Digger Phelps yesterday in that big win? He did the Irish jig. That's the dance of the week. And the basket of the week has to be Elmer Bennett right at the Carrier Dome, the trifecta. What that did is that puts the Fighting Irish, Notre Dame, they will be in the NCAA tournament as an independent. And the ball got beat yesterday by UAB. They are going to be knocked out of a chance to play in the NCAA unless they really turn it on and win the remaining games.
I didn't know Digger could jump that high.
He did a heck of a dance on that sideline. Did the little Irish jig.
Tonight, stay tuned to ABC for Life Goes On and America's Funniest Home Video. Then the new series about the legendary Elvis Presley, followed by the start of the ABC miniseries, The Kennedys of Massachusetts. That's tonight on ABC. Fast break points. Arizona. Like to talk about it. Well, there you see.
Well, Arizona really not able to run out in transition here today because of the speed and athletic ability of Vegas. And Vegas really loves to run. That's their game. Run, baby, run. I think he heard too much of me on the air right now. I got a little bored and tired, and I'm tired of Dickie. That's okay.
Well, you see, there is too much noise sometimes can have that effect on you.
Oh, gee.
I used to sleep through drag races, I know.
Uh-oh.
All right, they have to put David back into the lineup now. They need some help out of him because Stokes is gone. And here's David. Oh, he did have a shot and didn't take it. Goes to Ostick. Ball slapped away. Rooks inside. Yeah.
He has really improved. He plays with so much more confidence now on the inside. Has a good touch around the basket.
Yeah, you know, a year ago when they beat UNLV over at Tucson, we did that game. He just wasn't that kind of player.
Well, they had a guy by the name of Sean Elliott. He dominated that game.
Right.
Muehlbach gets the foul. That's why I feel he's done such a great job again, Lou Olsen. You lose an Anthony Cook, a first rounder. You lose an unbelievable player in Sean Elliott who can make the special play.
Well, another guy that they don't talk about much, Dick, is a Lofton.
Oh, Kenny Lofton.
He can run up the court.
But see, what they lack when you look at this Arizona team is that one special player who can make the big play, especially on the road. Sean Elliott was that kind of player.
Yep.
Look at Tark. Come on, relax a little, Tark.
Well, it's 2:24 to play in a ball game and a 10-point, perhaps 11-here lead. That rings quite loudly for the running Rebels.
They've won 18 in their last 20, 12 of their last 13, 7 in a row.
But here's the thing about the UNLV, Dick, is Anderson Hunt now has 6 points only, and yet they've taken what Arizona gave them and made the most of it.
That's a key point when you just said, Keith, as they dump the ball inside, and there's the foul. Looks a little emotional. You made a key point about taking what was there. Hunt didn't really force the shots. He didn't force opportunities that weren't there. They were going inside consistently. Had a running Ruffles women's program is sensational. They're number two in the nation for Louisiana Tech.
A foul goes to Larry Johnson. That's four on him now. Brian Williams coming back, and he'll replace Womack.
Balance in the country. It's incredible. I believe there are 25 teams that have a legitimate chance to get to the promised land, a la Michigan and Seton Hall last year, who did not even win their respective conferences. Michigan was number three in the Big Ten, and unless they get it in high gear this year, they'll finish behind Purdue and also Michigan State.
Are the Musketeers going to be a surprise this year?
Hey, Xavier, I'll tell you what. You talk about Peter Gillen. He is, to the middle major level, he is the Mike Krzyzewski of that level. Peter Gillen is an absolute solid gold coach.
Everybody's
too. He does have some players, but an excellent program and only two losses. I know they'd love to have him down in Virginia. They may not admit it. They'd love to have Gillen there replacing Terry Howland. I think he's going to stay at Xavier.
9-point lead for the running Rebels at 2 minutes to go in the game.
Not all the time, though. I believe that he has a job in mind. Right now, they're going to kill some time, spread the court, go to a little one-on-one.
Stacey Augman.
So they're going to spread the court, look for the high percentage of layup. Draw the defense to him and dump it off. A little dribble drive. Drive the gap. Showing some poise and discipline.
Hunt puts it in.
Best news right there, getting the high percentage layup, is that Hunt is okay after hitting the deck.
Your door slammer right there.
Brooks. I'll tell you what, Sean Rooks is a big-time drop-step player. He
Johnson's gone. I think Johnson got it.
Well, I'll tell you what, with a minute and 20 with the lead right now, he gets the standing ovation as a walk off the floor. Look at Larry. He's gonna go to the baseline. He knows he's got five. He wants to make the walk just a little bit longer. Look at Larry. He's milking it. He's going to get the roar. 26 points. Look at him milking it. Now he's going to take the long walk, and here they come. Here comes the standing O.
Hey, baby. This is Las Vegas.
Look at him politicking. Look at him. He's a politician. Unbelievable. Senator Johnson. He's waiting and waiting and waiting, and now he's going to make the entrance off the floor, the exit, rather. They're going to have to get a security guard to drag him off. Look at him. Look at him now. He's talking and committing. Wants a few more shakes. They're pointing to everybody. The crowd loves him. And there he goes. Bye-bye. Oh, you hot dog. Oh, you hot dog. I tell you, he's a beautiful kid. I love him. Great personality. Great personality.
James Jones replaces him, number 34, as Sean Rooks hits the free throw.
That's got to be the longest exit in the history of basketball going to the sideline when you get the fifth. And I'll tell you what, if he played poorly, he would have broken the world record for the sprint to the sideline and set at the end and hit. But he knew that he had that match. Come on, look at Timmy Gergensen. We love you here, Larry. We love you. You're a great player, Larry. Look at my arm around you, assistant coach.
Wildcats get it on a turnover, but then give it right back. That's Spurry. He lost it for a moment, but being the bigger man, takes it away from Hontek. And you get a foul down in the corner on David.
Scurry just looks like a battler to me. He looks like he belongs in a ring as a champ in fighting. He's from out of Brooklyn, New York.
What kind of a chin does he have?
I don't know. That's the thing. Uh-oh, Missouri, Oklahoma next week. Get ready, Norm Stewart. It's going to be maybe a little revenge time. They got beat by two today, and Missouri will be number one. Oklahoma, 43 in a row at home.
Missouri jumped out to what, a 19-5 lead, something like that today?
Oh, I love Anthony Peeler. He's electrifying. Norm Stewart, you talk about a guy that's lost a lot of players. He loses Gary Leonard. He loses Byron Irvin. He loses Sam Cody and Church. And here he is. He has number one in the nation. And what about the Big 8 conference?
Wildcats keep the ball down in the corner at 59 seconds to go in the game. And that's a foul on Jones.
Jones lost his starting job, started earlier in the year, but lost that starting job to David Butler the day he became eligible. The Big Ten is still the number one conference, Keys, from top to bottom. But the Big Eight definitely has stepped in and broken up the Big Four, which has been the Big East, the ACC, the SEC, plus the Big Ten. But now they've moved in because the SEC right now is really not a strong super league because of Kentucky and Florida not being the kind of teams that they've had in the past. But it runs in cycles, and the SEC will be back. Because Kentucky's going to be outstanding. There's no doubt about Ricky Pitino. He will get it done at Kentucky.
Brooks here trying to cut the UNLV lead to 7. And
they're still hanging in here, Keith. There's a little hope. A little hope. Seems stranger things happen.
He takes Rooks out. Doesn't want him on defense. He's got 4 fouls.
Well, he's rotating. He's playing the shift now. All they got to do is play intelligent here, and there's no way they lose the game. I spread the court. Is that intentional or what? That's not an intentional foul. 2 shots in the ball. Keith, something has to be done. I've said it time and time again at the end of a game. They just take forever. And I think one of the ways to clear it up, Ed Stites, the number one rules guy, we must maybe go to the international rule where you have the opportunity to shoot the ball or take the ball out of bounds. Now you tell me if he's not trying to deliberately stop the clock right here. I mean, that's a tackle move. That's a tackle. I mean, that's unbelievable. That play belongs in the NFL. It's an intelligence play, especially if they give him a one-on-one.
45 seconds, back to 8 points for the running rebel. Keith Jackson, Vic Vitale, Mark Amento, our statistician. Bill Webb directed it, Kenny Wilton produced it, Woody Fryman, our associate director. Rich Gilbert, our technical director.
They got to think 3 at every possession.
Bushler lets it go.
And there it is. They keep it a little interesting.
36 seconds. It's now 6 points.
I'll tell you the one thing about Arizona today, even if they get out of here with an L, they don't get an L for effort. Their effort has been supreme.
This means nothing in the respective conferences, but it sure is seasoning for the coming tournament.
When you fly in United, you're probably not aware of the 60,000 professionals working to make your trip easy, or the way our new advanced terminals speed you on your way. Just as when you use the American Express card, you're not really thinking about all the services that make frequent business flyers rated best for travel and entertainment. You don't notice these things because they're there, but you would notice them if they weren't.
Where did the Brooklyn High Five Flyers get the latest Nike basketball shoes? Size 16 to 8.5.
Where else are you going to go?
Where did the gum ringers of Normal, Illinois get Nike cross trainers for their entire family?
Where else are you going to go?
There's a team right there, Dick, that might be troublesome come March.
A lot of young, dominant players. They got to learn to play better on the defensive end, give up a lot of points, but they certainly have unbelievable potential. I would want to play them at tournament time. Then would an explosive guy like Chris Jackson and Shaquille O'Neal, certainly a diaper dandy. And Dale Brown does a great job at postseason where motivation is so important. He emotionally gets his people to play in that one-game shot situation.
Williams, that's right, on the 2 points of the ball game.
Yeah, he lost the battle on that baseline, no doubt about it. Williams certainly did a good job defensively, and he's been scoring lately. He started the year, 2 possessions, bring it out for 3, and it's a walk.
He hit the baseline.
On the baseline first, yeah.
Well, 2-3 points, you got a tie ball game, but he could not control it. And that got a little palpitation of the old ticker amongst the home folks, didn't it?
I'll tell you what, you've got to really appreciate their effort here. Incredible. Most teams would have folded up away from home, down in double figures. And this guy looks as good now as when the game started. Now, one here out of place. It's incredible.
He's
not allowed a team to shoot 50% except today, UNLV, 56. We talked about it earlier. Arizona second in the nation in field goal percentage defensively. That's Tony McAndrew he's talking to, outstanding assistant coach, has some head coaching experience. He's at Colorado State.
The Pac-10 will have a tournament this year. There is a postseason tournament for them, but this will be the last year. They are quitting it after this.
That seals it, Keith, right there, up seven. The guitar with the towel, another W.
That's 102 out of 108 in this building.
Why does he chew on a towel? I still haven't found why a towel. So many other things he could chew on. Have a candy bar on
better
the sideline.
Better than a shoe.
Well, chew on a candy bar. They ought to feed him some candy bars.
He gets fat.
I mean, incredible.
You know how it started? It started because he was thirsty, and somebody soaked the towel in water. That started. Of course, this is the symbol of the building, the Shark Tank. I wonder if those two bankers, Thomas and Mack, had any idea that this kind of... You know, we went on here last night at a tractor pull. Mounds of dirt and huge machines, and they got it ready somehow for the basketball game today.
It's multi-purpose building. There it is. Just playing it out now, following it every sequence. That's why I say the game's taking eternity. At the end, Ed Stites, you got to do something. Ed, take another bite, Jerry. Take another bite. Come on.
8-point lead and back to the foul line.
I mean, how many games have we had this year where it's been forever to play the last 4 minutes? It creates a boring situation for the fans at the end.
I agree.
And it really creates a dilemma when you got to get on a plane at about 3:50 and you're hanging here, but I'm taking you to carry my luggage, and you're going to struggle as I roll in about 2, 3 in the morning tonight in West Lafayette.
I'm staying the night.
I know. You'll be here relaxed with your lovely wife having dinner, and I'm sprinting through airports trying to get to a game.
I'm going to go see my friend Rich.
You're going to go see Little tonight?
Yeah.
Aw. You know how to hurt a guy. I wonder if he can do a Dick Vitale. I bet he can't do a Dick Vitale.
Look, I've spent the afternoon with you. I don't want to spend the night with you.
I want an old Nelly. An old Nelly. Give me an old Nelly.
Oh, baby.
Oh, baby. I got you saying.
Schmidt puts it up.
He's a three-point shooter, Schmidt.
That's his role. Moses Curry has played a pretty good ball game today for
Nevada,
Las Vegas.
There's another foul. And the crowd loves it. Look at Moses, the champ. I'm going to call him the nickname, the champ. Look at Anderson. He was quiet today. But he made some steady plays, getting the ball inside to the horses.
Wessler got that foul, Vic, and he's gone. So they fouled him out a lot. This year you lost Stokes and Bushler on fouls with Williams 4 and, or is it Brooks that got on? Who did it? They showed Bushler a moment ago.
Yeah, it is Bushler. He's going to go out of the game. Played a solid game, really. I'll tell you one thing also about Lute Olson's team as we look at Jerry Tarkanian. He doesn't dodge people. He plays against good people.
Yep.
Out of the conference, he wants to play against strong people to get ready for the postseason. He's got a date with Duke.
Yeah.
That's been some interesting basketball between Duke and Arizona. Some people say the coach of the Olympic team will come down between Mike Krzyzewski and Lute Olson. Can't go wrong with either one of those two. They stay with a college guy.
94-84.
Krzyzewski's got to go a long way to dress with this guy. Mike McKay, he doesn't buy his kind of friends, I'll tell you that. His wife Nikki saying, what do you need?
The 11-point lead. David brings it down into the corner, and it's good out of the corner by Muehlbach.
Not enough, but Jerry Tarkanian wins his eighth in a row, and they're rolling, baby. They're not going to lose another game the rest of this year. They will be the number one seed in the West. The only way you can lose is if something happens to one of his key players, an injury or academics or whatever.
Dick, you have a good trip to West Lafayette.
I will, and you enjoy the Rich Little show tonight, and you know how to hurt a guy, but I love it in West Lafayette. That's a great place to be.
UNLV 95, Arizona 87. Now, except on the West Coast, stay tuned for your local news and World News Sunday over most of these ABC stations.
ABC's College Basketball.
has been brought to you by the new generation of Oldsmobile. Step into the future now at your Oldsmobile dealer. By Magnavox, smart choices for smart people. Magnavox, smart, very smart. By BF Goodrich TA Tires, the athletic shoes for your car. And by Michelob Dry, bold taste with no aftertaste. Mick Dry refreshes completely. This has been a presentation of ABC Sports, recognized around the world as the leader in sports television.
A promotional fee has been paid to ABC by United Airlines, rededicated to giving you the service you deserve. Come fly the friendly skies.